Alright, hello guys, how's it going? In today's video, we're going to be talking about another potential tornado outbreak this Sunday, literally a week from our last tornado outbreak, and you're going to see it actually looks like the same exact regions. Very, very unfortunate setup that we're looking at for this Sunday. Now, before I get started with this video, though, I would ask that you do subscribe if you do like weather-related content, and also make sure to share this video with your friends, family, and social media. Now, for today's comment of the day, I want to know, do you prefer hamburgers or hot dogs? And let me know why. Give me some good reasons, and I'll be picking one of those for tomorrow's video. Let's get into this video, though, and we're going to be looking at our day one categorical outlook. We're just going to go through these. We're not looking at much severe weather on this day. You can see California, Kansas, Oklahoma might get a little bit of severe weather, as well as Florida, but really only a general thunderstorm risk for most areas, and maybe a little bit of a marginal risk there for Kansas and Oklahoma, but really nothing much. Then as we move towards tomorrow, only general thunderstorm risks for four different areas. And then as we move towards Saturday, you can see that we will have two different areas of marginal risk. The severe weather is getting a little bit ramped up by this point. We can see Virginia, North Carolina, as well as down there for Texas, Louisiana, and Arkansas. We have a marginal risk, but nothing much. So you might be wondering, where is our severe weather outbreak? Well, here's your day four probability outlook, and this looks almost identical to what we were looking at back last Sunday. We can see that there is a 15% chance for that yellow region for most of the deep south and south central United States, as well as some of the southeast. And then we have that 30% orange region, and that usually means that we're going to see an enhanced moderate or above risk for that area for Louisiana, Mississippi, Alabama, and a little bit of Georgia. Maybe a little bit further south than last Sunday, but just like a little bit of a tick south. Really looks almost identical. So we're going to go through, we're going to talk about the simulated radar on the GFS and the European model, and look at some of those severe weather implications. All right, so here we go. We're looking here at our simulated radar on the GFS, and as you can see, we have a low-pressure system located over Oklahoma by about 8 a.m. on Sunday, but still, we're not looking at much yet. So we're going to see this low-pressure system continue to move south, actually, and this is when things are going to get really interesting. So let's take it to 2 p.m., and we can see this moves into mostly like Arkansas, Texas, Oklahoma corner there. We're still just seeing showers around. Nothing much yet. We're really just seeing showers. It's as we head towards about 8 p.m. on Sunday that we're going to see things get really interesting. But let's take a look at that Cape first off, and we can see that those pinks and oranges are showing up all over the place for Texas, Oklahoma, Arkansas, Louisiana, Mississippi, Alabama. This is that thunderstorm fuel that's really going to allow these storms to really get ramped up and just start to become very, very severe as we head towards Sunday afternoon and evening, and then head towards Sunday night into Monday. That's when things are going to get really, really interesting here. So we're about to move on, and we're going to take a look at the simulated radar for Sunday at about 8 p.m. after it's eaten all this Cape up, our thunderstorm fuel, and see how severe they look by that point. And here we are. You can see a significant difference from 2 p.m. to 8 p.m. We can see reds showing up all over the place for Louisiana, Mississippi, Arkansas, and this just looks almost identical to last Sunday on Easter. If you were keeping track with our live stream that day, you see that this was pretty much how the radar was set, but maybe at about 2 p.m. last Sunday, this is looking like 8 p.m., so a little bit later of a setup here, which is worse, but really we're seeing almost identical areas here having that severe weather. Now let's move on, and we're going to take a look at our bulk shear first off for later that night, and you can see it's very, very high. We see reds for Mississippi, Alabama, Georgia, and a bit of Tennessee as well. The purples are sufficient for tornado activity as well, though, and we see that for Louisiana, in through Mississippi, Alabama, Florida, Georgia, and Tennessee once again. Almost identical areas where we saw our major tornadoes last Sunday, so I think we're looking at a potential for another major tornado outbreak just 1 week from our previous tornado outbreak. Let's take it back to simulated radar here at that same hour, and you can see we have a pretty strong area of thunderstorms in Mississippi, Alabama, and Georgia. Again, almost identical locations to what we were looking at last Sunday. Very, very interesting to see this play out this way. Let's take it to about 8 a.m., and you can see it moves through Georgia, South Carolina, North Carolina, just like last Sunday. And then as we move towards about 2 p.m. on Monday, we see those thunderstorms finally arrive for North Carolina, Virginia, and the Delmarva, though I think it's going to be so cold for those regions that we're probably going to be looking at mostly some stronger showers, not really any thunder with that or much severe weather up there in the north. It is going to be a little bit of a colder day this Monday rather than last Monday. All right, now we're about to move on, and we're going to take a look at the total rainfall from that model, and then we're going to move on to our European model and take a look at the same things and just see what the differences are here on the European model, which is typically more accurate. Now, I had mentioned that this is typically more accurate, but not only is it typically more accurate, it was also more accurate last week for last week's severe weather outbreak. So we're going to take this one very, very seriously. But here's your GFS, first off with the rainfall. And you can see that we have Louisiana, Mississippi, Alabama, Georgia, South Carolina, North Carolina, and Virginia. Again, maybe not looking at severe thunderstorms, but probably a lot of rain. The blues is anywhere from half an inch to 2 inches of rain, and then the pinks is 2 inches to 6 inches of rain. So looking at a lot of rainfall here for the Southeast, Mid-Atlantic, and Deep South. Now let's move on to the European model. Like I said, very, very accurate model. Did a very good job last week. And we can see that this is only at about 2 a.m. on Sunday, and we're seeing some thunderstorms possibly for Louisiana and Arkansas. Now this would actually eat up some of the potential severe weather, so we're going to have to watch this closely because this would actually kind of hinder the chance for severe weather and not enhance it. Now let's take it to 8 a.m. and you can see those showers move through Mississippi, Alabama, and even Louisiana and Arkansas. And actually, this is exactly what happened last week. Very interesting to see these earlier showers showing up here, possibly thunderstorms as well. Then as we move towards about 2 p.m., you see our severe thunderstorm start up for Louisiana and Texas there. Very, very deep oranges. This color shade on this website does not have a red, so that's basically as deep as the colors go. As far as rainfall, very, very strong thunderstorms this model is picking up on. Let's take it all the way to 8 p.m., which is when the GFS had most of the severe weather starting up. And you can see it's mostly for northern Louisiana there, the southeastern corner of Arkansas, and then in through portions of Mississippi as well. This looks very, very similar to last week. Now we're about to move on, and what we're going to do is we're going to take a look at what kind of shear this model is looking at, and then we're going to take the simulated radar all the way to where it's in the Mid-Atlantic once again. Now the shear is important because this is what usually leads to more tornado activity, and you can see that we have those purples all around by this point at about 2 a.m. on Monday for Louisiana, Mississippi, Alabama, Georgia, and even the southeastern corner of Tennessee that had a tornado with our last outbreak as well. This is going to be very sufficient for supercell and tornado development, and I think a tornado outbreak once again this Sunday for the Deep South and the Southeast, looking very similar, not quite as amplified as last Sunday. I think there's a little less potential with this Sunday, thankfully, but it is still probably going to be an enhanced risk, maybe even a moderate risk, just not quite as severe as last Sunday, in my opinion. Now, let's take it back to simulated radar, and you can see by about 8 a.m., on Monday, we're going to see those thunderstorms move through the same area, South Carolina and North Carolina. By morning time, we could possibly see some tornado activity once again for Georgia and South Carolina, which is what we saw last Monday morning, very, very early Monday morning. We actually, I think, saw an EF4 in South Carolina, so very, very active tornado pattern for you guys as well. And we're seeing those thunderstorms move up into North Carolina. Let's take it to the Mid-Atlantic, and you can see they arrive for coastal North Carolina, maybe even the northeastern corner of North Carolina and the southeastern corner of Virginia there. Very, very interesting to see it showing those thunderstorms move up into the same regions that we saw it last Sunday. Now, we have to be hoping that this does not lead to as bad of a tornado outbreak as last Sunday, because that was one of the worst that we've seen in a few years, and possibly going to go down as the worst of this year. Hopefully it goes down as the worst of this year, because that would mean we don't have any more that are that bad anymore. But this one is looking very, very similar as far as the areas, and it's looking very similar as far as the implications. Just all of the implications seem a little bit weaker. So our shear seems a little bit less. Our cape seems a little bit more, which would lead to possibly more hail and more developed thunderstorms. But that wind stuff is looking a little bit weaker, so I'm looking at a little bit less chance for damaging winds, a little bit less chance for tornadoes this Sunday as opposed to last Sunday, which is obviously good news, but I think the supercells could have a little bit of a higher precipitation amount, so we could be looking at more hail this Sunday than we did last Sunday, and we didn't see a lot of hail on Easter, so I think that this is going to be a little bit of a different setup, same location though, if that makes any sense. Anyway, for today's comment of the day, I asked you guys, do you prefer pancakes, waffles, or French toast? And Jensen Blevins, I think he's won a comment of the day before, but he said French toast, less messy and easier to eat. And I can't agree anymore. This got 6 likes, so definitely a lot of people agreed there. I absolutely love French toast, but especially my girlfriend's French toast. She made some for me yesterday morning while I was making my video. That was absolutely awesome. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for watching this video. Again, be sure to share it with your friends, family, and social media. I will see you guys in the next video.